Free yourself, boy! Roy, over here.
Yes, sir. Hold on. Let me read this.
This dragon would be a bit more supportive, seeing how we're trying to free it.
Lemire, why did the dwarf thing want this armor so badly? What's so special about it?
There are many legends behind the Dveigrath Ikar. A suspicious amount of legends, which makes confirming anything about this particular armor difficult. But the one constant among them is the ability of the armor to offer ultimate protection. A useful attribute for an unpopular king, you see.
Yet this plagued land is all that remains of him. This is why you do not trust legends, boy.
Well, what can you trust?
Yourself, your eyes, your instincts. Blind trust in a legend is a gamble, and rarely does it pay off.
If you say so.
Enjoy freeing them.
Well, yeah. Still seems like the right thing to do.
Follow me, Atreus.
Yes, sir. we go. Huh. It's kind of run down in here.
What did you expect?
I don't know. Less ruin, I guess. Maybe the throne room's in better shape. Do you hear that?
No. What do you hear, boy?
Crying. And screams. Large crowd of people.
Just old spirits, I suppose. Leftover victims of the Mad Dwarf's reign. Still, that's rather ominous.
They're getting louder. They sound almost like... Hellwalk!
Oh! I felt that one, brother.
Hellwalkers. Hey, look at this. Blood trail.
Where's the passage behind this throne?
A secret passage!
Well, wouldn't be a proper throne room without a secret passage.
Look here.
Huh. Interesting. I may want to write that down.
Here, boy. Another one.
Stargather. Wow. That's a lot of arms.
That's fair to say.
Six? Seven? Eight? Could he shoot four bows at once?
More of a swordsman.
Come, boy.
The things you pulled from him. Those must be the three mythical ingredients Brock was talking about.
I can say with utmost certainty that I've never laid eye on a stranger set of objects in my life.
How are Brock and Sindri supposed to build with... whatever they are?
Don't count the dwarves out, lad. They're right pricks, but they're resourceful. They once made an unbreakable chain out of little more than a cat's footstep and bird spit.
That doesn't even make sense.
Well, that's the legend. If you wanted sense, you shouldn't be talking to a severed head.
Why do they call Odin the Lord of the Hang?
That refers to a modest example of Odin's thirst for knowledge. The time he spent 9 days a dead man. hung himself by the neck from Yggdrasil's branches, put his spear through his own side, and bled down into the Well of Destiny. He roamed the realms of the dead and plundered the World Tree of its secrets, until I think, quite rightly, it got fed up with him and sent him back to the Land of the Living. Did I not mention he was barking mad?
You boys look right.
They found the materials. But they're so weird. How do you build a piece of armor out of something so... so...
Nanya.
Nanya?
Nanya fucking business. Trade secret. We got our ways.
Oh.
What'll it be?
Don't scuff that up.
Well, what else?
are we talking about?
Let's get to it.
See you next, whereas I see you.
Here we go! I can't believe we're gonna see the giants!
Well, if things worked according to plan, go ahead and lock in Jotunheim and we'll be on our way. Probably. Not sure why anyone would want to come here, but here we are.
It smells bad. What is this stuff?
This mist is cursed.
Cursed?
Quite right. Safe to breathe for a time, but it'll kill if we linger. Just one more reason to love Niflheim.
Boy.
Yes, sir. Let's see.
Ah! Fancy seeing you two here.
I'm surprised you're here, Sindri. This mist is pretty gross.
You think I can't handle a little cursed mist? Well, you're right. I'm trying to build some armor that will lessen its effects. The materials I need are all right here in Ivaldi's workshop, but they're blanketed by this nauseating mist, of course.
Wait for it.
The last known location for such armor is in the workshop's center chamber. The entrance is sealed, but I could craft you an entry stone with enough mist echoes.
There it is.
I wouldn't recommend staying in the mist for too long. That stench will stick to your hair, your weapons, your armor. And I will not touch your gear until you burn all the tiny beasties off in the fires of Muspelheim. Also, it will kill you. Ivaldi sure did a number on this place. Not that there was much to see before. Still, the echoes remain, ready for plunder.
There's something written here. This whole place shuffles around each time we leave? That's incredible!
Atreus, focus. This is a dangerous place.
That's dwarven creativity for you. Impressive and dangerous.
Yeah!
Brother! Get up, brother!
Brother, that curse!
Ooh, looks like you found enough echoes. And you're not dead. Very impressive.
Sindri, how do you make anything out of mist?
Odd as it sounds, the dwarves who lived here could craft marvels out of the mists of Niflheim. Keep an eye out for more mist echoes. I could put them to all sorts of use. What speaks to you? Well, when you do need something, I'll be around.